Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In the last couple of videos, we have learned the fundamentals of Vue.js. Now I will start a new series, and in this series we will look into Vue components, which is one of the most powerful feature of Vue.js. In case if you have not watched the series on Vue.js basics, then I recommend you to walk through the Vue.js basics before continuing this series. You can find the link of Vue.js basics playlist in the video description. And before moving ahead, if you are new to this channel, hit the red subscribe button and press bell icon so you could never miss our upcoming videos. Now let's start. So the question is, what is Vue components? The components are reusable Vue instance. They will let you create custom HTML elements which will behave exactly how you want them to. Now let's create our first component. Here I will create a counter component, which is very common example. Here you can see I have created this Vue instance. I think now we should extract this to its own JS file. So let's remove this. And here I will say app.js. Next, let's create an app.js file. And let's create Vue instance right here. Now to create Vue component, right here above this Vue instance, I will say Vue.component. Next, here I will pass any name to this component. Let's say the component name is counter. Here I want to mention that it is considered to use hyphen in component names as a best practice and try to use a unique name, so it should not clash with the official names, or if you use any Vue.js plugin in the application, so it should not clash with the plugin component names. Here I will use counter for example purpose. Next we pass options in curly brackets. The option for the component is almost identical to what we have previously passed to Vue instance. But in components we do not pass this EL option, because components are meant to be reusable and not bound to markup. Next, components have their own template, and that can be defined in couple of ways. The one way is using string. So let's say here I'll add a button, and in here I'll print count, and on click this button I will increment count. Now here we need count data. In Vue instance we pass the data property as an object like this. But in case of the components, the data property must be a function that returns an object, so that each instance can maintain an independent copy of the returned data object. So here I'll say data function and return object, and here I'll say count, and initially it is 0. Now very first component registered, and it is ready to use, and we can use this component like HTML element. Let's see this. Right here in this div, we can use counter tag. Now let's see this in browser. You can see here we have a button and it shows 0, and on click this button it increments by 1. As I already mentioned, components are reusable, so we can add as many instances of counter component as we want. Here I'll add counter components for a couple of times. Now in the browser we can see, here we have 5 counter components. Notice that when I click on the buttons, each one maintains its own separate count and it is not affecting the others. That is because each time we use a component, a new instance of it is created. This is all in this tutorial. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.